Let us do numericals based on calorimetry. Let us read out the second question. In the second question, it is said that a liquid of mass 0.2 kg having initial temperature 135 degrees centigrade is cooled to 25 degrees centigrade. If the specific capacity of the substance is 750 joules per kg degree centigrade, find heat energy given out. So heat energy, how much heat energy is liberated, that we have to find out when 0.2 kg of substance, its temperature decreases from 135 to 25. So as this change happens, whatever amount of the heat energy is liberated out, that we have to calculate. So the formula that we use is H is equals to mc theta. The heat we have to calculate, mass of the substance is given as 0.2 kg, specific capacity is 750 and change in temperature is 135 minus 25. So that is 0.2 into 750 into 110, which gives 16500 joules. This amount of the heat energy is released. Let us see one more sum. Let us see the third one of the practice problem 3. It is given that a burner supplies heat energy at the rate of 20 joules per second. Find the specific capacity of a solid of mass 25 gram if its temperature rises by 80 degrees centigrade. Let us write down the given data. The heat liberated per given time is 20 joules per second. So in every second, 20 joules of heat is coming out from the burner. Specific capacity is to be calculated, and the substance has mass of 25 grams and change in temperature is given 80 degrees centigrade. Please see here the words, if its temperature rises by 80 degrees centigrade. So these words clearly states that change in temperature is 80 degrees centigrade, and all this happens in a time 1 minute, converting this into seconds. Again, making use of the formula for calorimetry, H is equals to mc theta. Mass is given as 25 grams, convert it into kg. All should be converted into the SI unit. So converting gram into kg, dividing by 1000. So m, specific capacity, we don't know, we have to calculate, and theta is directly 80 degrees. And the heat energy, how much heat energy the burner has given out? 20 joules every second, and that for 60 seconds. So 20 joules every second, and totally for 60 seconds, 1200 joules of heat is liberated, making C as a subject. 1200, 1000 also gets multiplied this side. 2580 goes to the denominator. 25 fours are 2 fours are 0 0 6. So 60 joules per kg degree centigrade is the specific capacity of the substance. If we want to convert it into grams, then divide it with the 1000. So it will be joules per gram degree centigrade. So that will be 0.60 joules per gram degree centigrade. One zero I forgot here. That will be 1200 into 1000. So here it will be 1600. That is the correct answer, 0.6 joules per gram degree centigrade. Let us do another problem, the second one, or the practice problem 4. It is given that 400 gram of mercury of specific capacity 0.14 joules per gram degree centigrade is heated by 200 watt heater for 1 minute. 200 watt of heater for 1 minute and 40 seconds. If initially mercury is at 0 degree centigrade, calculate its final temperature. So this is again a very simple question from the calorimetry, and with the help of the same formula, H is equals to mc theta, it can be solved. Noting down the given data that the mass of the mercury given is 400 grams and specific capacity is also given 0.14 joules per gram degree centigrade, and heat is heated by a heater which has a power of 200 watts. Watts stands for joules per second. That means a heater of 200 watt can give 200 joules of heat energy every second. And this heater remains on for the time 1 minute and 40 seconds. 1 minute, 40 seconds. Converting this completely into seconds. 60 seconds, 40 seconds, that is 100 seconds. And they have given that initial temperature of the mercury is 0 degrees centigrade. What will be the final temperature? Let us start solving. Here the heater is giving the heat energy and the mercury is absorbing the heat energy. So heat given by heater is equals to heat gained by mercury. So heat given by the heater is power into time, and heat gained by the mercury will be mc theta. So power was 200, time was 100 seconds, mass of the mercury is 400 grams, spatial capacity is 0.14, and delta theta, which is change in the temperature. So final temperature will be something higher, minus initial temperature was 0 degrees centigrade. Let us try to solve this equation. 0, 0 goes from both the sides, so it will be 200 is equals to 4 into 0.56 into theta 5 minus 0 degree centigrade. So that will be 200 divided by 0.56 is equals to theta F. Okay, so 357.14 degrees centigrade is the final temperature, and that is the correct answer.